Hello children, continuation of alternating current. Now in that we can see the resonance. It's actually an interesting characteristics of the series of LCR circuit, this phenomenon of resonance actually. The phenomenon of resonance is a common among the systems that have a tendency to oscillate at a particular frequency. See, this frequency we can call it as the system's natural frequency. Okay, this bandwidth and the natural frequency we can call it as. See, we know that familiar examples that about this phenomenon of resonance is a child on a swing, if you have seen, and we have also come across this. The swing has a natural frequency for swinging back and forth like a pendulum, right? If the child pulls on the rope at regular intervals and the frequency of the pulse is almost the same as the frequency of swinging. See, the amplitude of the swinging will be what? It will be large, right? So for LCR circuit, we can driven a voltage of amplitude, which is Vm, and the frequency omega, which are found for the current amplitude. We can see that also we know that Im or I, which is equal to V by Z, is it right? And through the impedance we can relate that before in classes. So current we can say V by Z, or we can say E naught by R, I, which is equal to, right? Now the quality factor or Q factor, that is the sharpness of resonance, we can see the Q factor of the series resonance circuit, which is given here in the inductor of the sharpness of the resonance. So actually this is defined as, we can say that the ratio between the resonant frequency and the bandwidth, that is, which is nothing but quality factor, we can say that we can write it as omega R by omega 2 minus omega 1, or we can say that omega R into that omega 2 minus omega 1, which is nothing but the change in the omega, that is the bandwidth. So 2 omega, that we can say here the bandwidth, which is nothing but we can say this is 2 del omega, right? So where omega 1 and omega 2 are the frequencies of the current, which is at the 1 by root 2 here, we can say, and this is the resonant value actually. So we can say that omega 1, which is equal to what? Omega R minus del omega, and omega 2, which is equal to, we can say, omega R plus del omega, right? So the frequency range, we can say that omega 2 minus omega 1, which is equal to 2 del omega. That only we said that a bandwidth, right? So bandwidth, so this large value of the Q factor actually, which is nothing but the, through this you can understand, see the impedance which is equal to R, while W1, that means omega 1 and omega 2, it contains the value what we said, root 2 R, right? So we can say that Z, that impedance, which is equal to root of, you know that, R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C whole square, that is nothing but root 2 R. It is equivalent to root 2 R, or we can write this expression as R square plus omega L minus 1 by omega C the whole square, which is equal to 2 R whole square, right? Or we can write this expressions also, omega L minus 1 by omega C, which is equal to plus or minus R, is it right? See, we can write this omega L minus 1 by omega C plus or minus R. We have to write like this, omega 1 L minus omega 1 C, which is equal to minus R. and omega 2 L minus 1 by omega 2 C, which is equal to plus R. By adding these two equations, we will get omega 1 plus omega 2 into L minus 1 by C of omega 1 plus omega 2 by omega 1 omega 2, right, which is equal to 0. So, or else we can write this as omega 1 omega 2, which is equal to 1 by LC, right. See, we can subtract this also, these two equations. If suppose we subtract, what we will get, we can see now, okay. Now, if we subtract these two equations, we will get omega 2 minus omega 1 into L plus 1 by C omega 2 minus omega 1 by omega 1 omega 2, which is equal to, we are minus, so minus minus, so that 2R will get, or we can write this expression as omega 2 minus omega 1 into L plus 1 by C omega 1 omega 2, right, which is equal to 2R will come. So we can express and this further we can simplify it. So omega 2 minus omega 1, which is equal to, this is LC, so that we can write L plus L, which is equal to 2R, because omega 1 omega 2, which is equal to 1 by LC, right. So from this, omega 2 minus omega 1, which is equal to R by L. Okay. So what is the Q factor? We got the differences, the dull omega, we got 2 dull omega value, we got it. So we can apply this to that. So Q, which is equal to omega R by 2 dull omega, we know that. So which is equal to omega R L by R, right. So this we can say the value, Q factor of the series of LCR circuit, right. So by that way we can understand that we can define this as the ratio of the voltage drop which is across the inductance or capacitance, right, at the resonance to the applied voltage. See, if suppose we have taken that as omega R, suppose which is equal to 1 by root of LC, therefore what will come, omega R square, which is equal to 1 by LC, or we can write omega R L, which is equal to 1 by omega RC. See, by using this relation, we will get the Q value, which is equal to 1 by omega RCR, is it right? Which is equal to 1 by R into root of L by C, right?